SpaceX is trying to achieve another successful launch of its Starship rocket, later this summer. In the last few weeks, SpaceX has made fast progress in installing the water-cooled steel plate system that will be used starting on the next flight of Starship. Pad crews have been working non-stop on this system, welding and grinding and adjusting all of the hardware for a proper installation of the system. SpaceX now complete all the stuff with Orbital launch mount, and SpaceX get ready to test Starship water deluge system for the first time. Stay tuned as we dive into this and lots more in today's episode. SpaceX posts a tweet on X, and says that, the company has plans to test first full pressure test of the new Starship flame deflector, is planned for Friday. While the main central plate had been installed a few weeks ago, the manifolds that supply water to the system were installed shortly after. This whole system involves a six-sided central plate, with three sides connected to these manifolds, and the other three closed off. These three manifolds are located on the south and west sides of the central plate, under the orbital launch mount. Right after these were installed, pipes were also laid down to connect them to the ground storage tanks, located on the other side of the Starship launch tower. This test is completely different from what SpaceX done a few days ago. In the previous test, SpaceX just used three-side manifold in the water deluge system for flame deflector test. But this is different. In this test, SpaceX use all three side manifold and central plate with full pressure for the flame deflector test. There are two main water pipes that lead to the three manifolds. One of them splits in two near the ulm and supplies water to two of the manifolds, whereas the other pipe supplies water to the remainder. Pad crews have been working non-stop on this system, welding and grinding and adjusting all of the hardware for a proper installation of the system. During the last week, almost all of the repaired and upgraded launchpad systems were tested. One of the first tests occurred on July 13, with the purge of the pressure and water pipes that are part of the new water ground tanks. The day after, on July 14, there were up to 7 tests of the ulm Raptor quick disconnects that help start the outer 20 engines on Super Heavy. This was followed the day after by even more testing, but this time of the orbital tank farm. This testing seemed to be unsuccessful, with crews aborting the test a few hours afterward. The test that certainly attracted the most interest came on July 17, with the first water flowing through the pipes and up to the steel plate under the ulm. This started first at low pressure, just as a small trickle of water accumulated and poured over the sides of the plate. After a gradual increase in pressure, the test of this system culminated in a burst of water sprayed upwards under the ulm. This is believed to have only been a partial test, perhaps only using one of the three manifolds of the system, and at lower pressure. It could be very likely that a full flow and full-scale test may not be performed until it is needed for a static fire test, which won't come until after Booster 9 rolls out to the launch site. Another series of launch pad tests occurred on the evening of July 18, with heavy venting observed coming from the orbital tank farm. Ground cryogenic conduits were purged, as well as evidenced by the presence of the now famous ulm and launch tower vents related to this process. Even the launchpad FireX system was tested during this campaign, being activated for several seconds and proving that it is still in good shape ahead of the upcoming Booster 9 static fire test campaign. Booster 9 static fire test campaign could be starting as soon as next week. The vehicle was moved from the Mega Bay to Starbase's Rocket Garden in the very early morning of July 18. The vehicle then rolled down Highway 4 on Thursday, providing a closer look at the upgrades that include a set of cylindrical metal tanks installed in the locations where the smaller set of aerodynamic chines used to be located on the vehicle. These have now been covered, making now all of the chines on Booster 9 look the same size. It is unclear what is the nature of these tanks, but they could be related to anything, from extra storage of consumables for the booster, to storage of purging gas for the engine bay in order to avoid fires, something Elon had hinted at on a recent Twitter Spaces. With Booster 9 now on the pad, SpaceX is hoping for a full engine static fire test to be conducted before the end of the month. This would set the stage for the return of a Starship full stack in early August, and followed by a launch by the middle of that month. However, this will only be possible if weather, launch pad, and vehicle hardware cooperate. On top of this, SpaceX needs to be cleared for flight by the Federal Aviation Administration. This will include recertifying Starship's flight termination system, and modifying the rocket's launch license, to include this second flight, and any other potential modifications to the flight profiles, if they were needed. After its rollout, Booster 9 was seen sporting its new set of FTS charges, which are now larger in number. There are at least two more charges, at the bottom of the liquid methane tank, about two rings above the common dome weld line, where the original FTS charges are still located. These additional charges are in order to ensure that Booster 9 loses complete structural integrity, in the event that this system is needed and activated during flight, effectively terminating its flight. If SpaceX were to achieve a second launch of Starship in August, the company may perform another two launches of its monster rocket, in what remains of the year. Sources indicate that SpaceX may be targeting somewhere from 8 to 10 launches of Starship, in 2024, for the Falcon Heavy's next liftoff. The company announced via Twitter, via X, today, July 24, that launch will take place from NASA's Kennedy Space Center, KSC, in Florida. The coming mission will be the seventh for the Falcon Heavy, which was the world's most powerful operational rocket, until NASA's Space Launch System debuted on the Artemis 1 mission last November. SpaceX is working to get the title back with its next-gen Starship vehicle, which will be the most powerful rocket ever when it's up and running. Starship has flown once to date, on an April 20th test flight that ended with a commanded destruction 4 minutes after liftoff. The Falcon Heavy consists of three strapped-together first stages of the company's workhorse Falcon 9 rocket. The central booster is topped with an upper stage and the payloads. Those three first stages are designed to be reusable. If all goes according to plan, the two side boosters will come back to Earth about 8 minutes after liftoff, touching down at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, which is next door to KSC, SpaceX said via X today. The central booster will apparently not be recovered, due to the Jupiter 3 satellite's heft. At 10.1 tons, 9.2 metric tons, it will be the heaviest payload ever launched toward geostationary orbit, which lies about 22,200 miles, 35,700 kilometers, above Earth. The Falcon Heavy debuted in February 2018, on a highly anticipated test flight that sent Elon Musk's red Tesla Roadster into orbit, with a mannequin nicknamed Starman behind the wheel. Falcon Heavy has now launched a total of 6 times, including twice in 2023. The relatively low launch cadence to date is due in large part to delays in the development of the satellites, slated to fly on the powerful rocket, experts have said. Thanks for watching this video and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.